Ladies and gentlemen, it is 7:30 p.m. on this wonderful station of ours, BBC Radio 1, which means we bestow the hottest record in the world onto a brand new artist, band, or MC. Who is it? It's the Big Moon tonight, and the track is called It's Easy Then, and Jules joins us on the phone right now. Hello, Jules.
Hello.
Yes. It is good to hear your voice. It is good to have you back with new music. This is feeling very positive.
Yes. We are so happy and excited. Honestly, my heart is beating so fast. I can't believe we're finally putting songs out.
This is the first new music from you guys in 2 years. Like, is it a big moment coming back with brand new music after a first album's done?
Oh my God, yes. Like, we've been writing these songs for 2 years, so it feels like a kind of peak.
Okay, I tell you what are the rest of the band doing at this point? Are they all going to be gathered around the radio, or are they just sick of it? Like, we wrote it, we've heard it a million times, we've been in the studio.
I've got no idea where they are. I guess they probably are listening to the radio, like, wondering what I'm talking about.
Well, I'll tell you what, let's hear it right now. This is the hottest record in the world, the return of the Big Moon. It's Easy Then on Radio 1.
Now, this is the hottest record in the world.
I'm so bored of being capable. I need somewhere to be vulnerable. I take everything straight to the heart. Brace for an opening chapter to swallow me up. Your work is never done,
never done.
Yeah, it feels like your work has just begun. Now I walk into a room and forget why every new thought shows the others aside. I'm just waiting for the piano to fall. Brace for an opening chapter to swallow me up.
Record in the world.
There you have it. The Big Moon, It's Easy Then. Jules, you're back.
Yes, I'm back. There it is.
I like how you announced it earlier on Twitter. Getting your dog Pablo involved, using that pet trick for content is always okay with me.
Yeah, always. Like Pablo, I mean, he's not a great performer, but he does have a good face.
This single, it's easy then. It's like, this is the low-key, vulnerable anthem that I need in my life right now. It's so good.
Oh, thanks, man. I think this song kind of sums up a lot of our couple of years of writing, like trying to make sense of kind of chaotic worlds that we're living in. I think it's meant to be an anthem, and it's meant to make you feel better.
That's what the music is there for. Like, you know, from somebody who has definitely gone through the sort of doldrums of anxiety, like this anxiety anthem, like I can relate to it.
Yeah, we need more anxiety anthems.
Maybe that's
how you'll feel these days.
why do you think that is? Is it just like the over consuming of everything?
Yeah, I think it's just everything. Like, we're all just kind of too busy, and we're worried all the time, and we're all reading the news, and it's like constant information, and it's overwhelming. And you kind of need a break. You need a release.
At what point like does this track fit into like all the new music that you guys are making at the minute? Because it sounds quite different to a lot of the stuff that you were making on the first record. Was it a conscious decision to like experiment with the sound a little bit more?
Yeah, totally. Like, we really didn't want to limit ourselves to just guitars. Like, we just kind of wanted to explode everything we were doing. Like, we thought there's no point coming back with a second album that sounded exactly the same. And we all play lots of instruments, so we were like, let's just play around.
What's the sort of instrument that you picked up on this, or you guys picked up on it, you thought you'd never put on a record?
Oh my God. On this song, Fern is playing the trumpet.
Is she like qualified grade 8? Like, did she play in like marching band?
No, I think she maybe played the drums in a marching band once, but she's only been learning the trumpet for like a year, so it's kind of a big deal.
You know, like when you're in school and you're doing like music GCSE, they'll play you a piece of music and you have to pick out all the different instruments on it. Maybe we can use your album for that.
Oh my God, I had to do that in my music GCSE, and I had to work out all the notes from You Can't Hurry Love, Phil Collins version. I failed.
Of all of it. You failed music.
I failed music.
And yet here you are with the so hottest good. Record in the world. Do you want it? You could name and shame your music teacher right now if you wanted. But
No,
you're too good for that.
I do feel quite smug about it though.
You guys are going to be busy now coming up in September. You're going on tour with one of the most legendary bands there are about. You're going on tour with the Pixies.
Oh my God, we're going on tour with the Pixies.
Kim Deal is the coolest bass player of all time.
I know. Honestly, the Pixies are like the reason I play guitar. Like, they're my favourite band ever. And I still can't really believe it. Honestly, like, it's just, I'm completely baffled.
That's going to be so amazing. Like,
these are
big venues as well. So if you're going to the Pixies tour, you need to get down early to catch the big moon. That's how it works. So does this mean you guys are back on the circuit full time? You've got albums coming out, like your own tours, all the bells and whistles. Is this the beginning of it?
This is the beginning. Yeah, there's going to be lots more to come.
Do you know what? Life is good when the big moon are in it releasing music. So I think we should do the hottest record in the world. Because it's so nice, we're playing it twice. This is the big moon. It's easy then, Jules. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is the hottest record in the world.
I'm so bored of being capable. I need somewhere to be vulnerable. I take everything straight to the heart. Your work is just